And the church ladies with the fancy hats said, kick him to the curb, give him what he deserves. And the deacons with the nice suits and the silk ties said, kick him to the curb, give them what they deserve. And the judicial system and the school system and the foster care system and the legal system said, kick them to the curb, give them what they deserve. Then Jesus dropped the blood and the cross lifted love and eternity filled the soul, and God kicked in the mercy seat and the yoke of sin bowed in defeat, and the angels rejoiced as the sinner's name was written in eternity. Now naysayers, forgetting their sins too, grumbled and looked for someone who they could use to deflect the torment of their sins they felt inside, refusing God's love by refusing to love as God and let truth abide. You see, they go to the church, to religious cover. They say they come to Jesus, but they look for another. Therefore, they can play God and judge their brother while they smile with their church words and hide their hypocrisies, never falling to the knees to give prayers of intercessory. See, they use the sins of others to scapegoat. They have access to mercy still and the love boat. And they won't throw out the lifeline. Throw out the lifeline. Someone is drifting away and Satan is shifting while no one is praised. They just naysays, kick them to the curb, give them what they deserve. Nah, see, they'd rather alienate, exasperate, frustrate, perpetrate, fake love, play or hate, and demote, derail, discourage, depress, deflate. Instead of kingdom of God refugee camps, they set up living on earth as hell detainees through their negative prophecies, needing someone to measure themselves up against for the sake of religiosity. For we all like sheep have gone astray, and God has laid upon Jesus the iniquity of us all. But he was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities, and the chastisement of his peace was upon us, and we are healed. The addict, the drug dealer, healed. The pimp, the prostitute, healed. The murderer, which is same as a backbiter, the gossip and the slanderer, healed. The perverse, adulterer, fornicator, thief, and talebearer, healed. But they don't know it was purchased 400 years ago and made so that on a hill or far away stood an old rugged cross. They can't get around those church faces and those eyes that say, stone them, crucify them, kick them to the curb, give them what they deserve. They should live right and walk in the light while themselves they walk in the twilight, doo 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 doo, and they play church zombies, scaring folks with their religious ways. Scaring folks. And they hide the fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins, while their brains conjure up programs and rituals and standards to say, walk this way, talk this way, hallelujah, thank you God, in the sweet by and by, walk this way, serve this way, and they take this cloak of works and bondage and never know liberty to be set free, never know grace, really? This is not new, because the children of old Israel did it too. They said, crucify him, kick him to the curb, give him what he deserves, put him in jail, take him to hell, act like the Son of God with all that blasphemy in his heart, give him an ugly, shameful death on a tree with a thorny crown for all to see. He called himself the Son of God, they said with envy, and they pouted and they spouted and they shouted, let his blood be upon us and our children's children. Pilate said, I find no fault in him, but let his blood be upon us and our children's children. Let his blood be upon us and our children's children. They pouted and shouted and spouted, and God said, I'll take that. Thanks for the agreement and amen, man, because that was the plan. Rope-a-dope. The enemy confused that through the cross of death abused, Jesus Christ would die and be lifted and draw all sinners convicted. The ownership of the soul of man was going to take a violent shift. So Jesus marched into hell with a can't hold my body down drift. See, the keys of hell from the enemy's hands were stripped and the veil of the temple was ripped. And he said, come unto me, all you heavy laden, my disobedient, my stiff-necked, my rock-headed, my hard-hearted, my bull-headed, my double-minded, my two-faced, my spiritually fornicating, spiritually adulterous, undeserving children who groped in darkness night. I am your soul light. I come to make you right that you may know Jesus Christ. See, you were created in my image in the earth, and the earth groans and travails for you to get a clue and know me as you know you and advance the kingdom like you supposed to bring mercy to souls of men with truth within. See, men, healed men walk as trees, life modeling Jesus Christ, bring forth healing for a nation riddled with spiritual identity strife. For a nation riddled with spiritual identity strife. See, I look for someone enlightened to stand in the gap, not judge and put them down, but deliver them from the sin trap. Who will be and live like Christ's roadmap? I look for someone who will look at them with truth. I look for someone who will look at them as I do, with love, piercing eyes of truth, so they no longer hear the accuser of the brother, but they find liberty within. Not my will that any perish. It is not God's will that any perish. But if you don't go, how will they know? See, if you can't go past yourself and love like I do, how will they know the truth? What I've done for you, I've done for them too. See, Jesus said he shed his blood as remission for their sins, paid in full, already on deposit, no balance due, already on deposit, no balance due. The blood covers. It is on the mercy seat in reserve for all who choose to turn from sin and receive grace what they did not deserve. There is a fountain filled with blood, run from Emmanuel's veins, and sinners plunge beneath that blood, lose all their guilty stain, lose all their guilt and stain.